Here are some of the pros and cons of drinking coffee. Number one, coffee supports happiness. One study from a few years back confirmed what many of us intuitively believe. Coffee is happy juice. Researchers found that drinking coffee is linked to positive emotions, including pleasure, kindness, affection, satisfaction, friendship, calm, and yes, happiness. The findings also noted that no negative emotions were tied to coffee consumption. Number 2. Coffee contains antioxidants. Coffee beans are actually the seeds inside a small bright red or yellow fruit. Both the seeds and fruits are rich in antioxidants. In fact, one study found coffee to be the single greatest contributor to total antioxidant intake. This is likely because 65% of American adults say they drink coffee, while only 1 in 10 eat the minimum recommended 5 daily servings of fruits and veggies. In other words, coffee becomes the top source of antioxidants by default. Nonetheless, the antioxidants in coffee have been linked to health protection. Chlorogenic acid is a polyphenol abundant in coffee, has been shown to reduce inflammation, and it may play a key role in protection against chronic diseases, including obesity. And just in case you're wondering about the coffee fruit, it can be turned into compost or dried and brewed as tea. It's also been used in products like energy drinks, since the fruit also contains caffeine. Number 3. Coffee may reduce the risk of type 2 diabetes. A 2018 meta-analysis of 30 previously published studies concluded that coffee consumption is inversely associated with the risk of type 2 diabetes. Researchers found that chance of developing the disease decreased by 6% for each cup per day increase in coffee consumption. Scientists say that possible reasons for the link include coffee's antioxidative and anti-inflammatory effects, ability to boost calorie burning, and impact on the content and diversity of health-protective gut microbes. Number 4. Coffee is tied to lower rates of other diseases. Studies show that coffee consumption may protect against certain cancers, including breast, colorectal, endometrial, and prostate cancers, as well as heart disease and Parkinson's disease. Lifelong coffee / caffeine consumption is also associated with prevention of cognitive decline and a reduced stroke risk. In terms of brain health, caffeinated coffee ups alertness and may also improve memory for up to 24 hours after consumption. Number 5. Coffee isn't dehydrating if you're consistent. Coffee has long been criticized for contributing to dehydration due to its diuretic effect, which triggers fluid loss. However, newer research indicates that after about 4 days of consistent caffeine intake, your body adjusts, which negates the dehydrating effect. The trick is, you have to be consistent. In other words, if you sometimes have one cup of coffee in the morning, sometimes three, or if you occasionally reach for it in the afternoon, you may feel the diuretic side effects such as headache and low energy. Potential downsides to consider. How caffeine affects your body is linked to your genes. People who are genetically slow metabolizers of caffeine actually have an increased risk of heart attack, high blood pressure, and prediabetes after increasing caffeinated coffee consumption, whereas fast metabolizers do not carry these risks. For slow metabolizers, research also shows that caffeine inhibits athletic performance rather than enhancing it. For some people, caffeine can also trigger digestive irritation, including heartburn, as well as an upset stomach, anxiety, rapid heartbeat, and rebound fatigue. Finally, coffee consumption during pregnancy is linked to low birth weight, preterm birth, and pregnancy loss.